Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel. The good news that we want to send to everyone today. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle pledge $117,000 to a hunger charity during the coronavirus crisis. Prince Harry and Meghan have arranged for money generated from their wedding broadcast to go toward feeding hungry children during the coronavirus pandemic. The couple pledged just over $117,000 to the charity Feeding Britain for its programs across the UK, which provide families in need with hot meals and food packages. The funds have been called a godsend by the organization's national director, Andrew Forsey, and come from excess profits from the BBC's Royal Wedding broadcast. The Archbishop of Canterbury, who presided over the Sussexes' May 2018 marriage, is president of Feeding Britain. Harry and Meghan told him they wanted the money to be donated to the organization during a phone call held around the time schools across the UK were closing their doors to most children. A spokesperson for Harry and Meghan said they are delighted to see the money go to such a great cause. It had been agreed at the time of Harry and Meghan's wedding that if there were any excess profits from the BBC broadcast, that money would go to a charity nominated by the couple. They were notified about the funds around the time the coronavirus pandemic was taking hold. It is understood the Sussexes thought it was fitting that funds generated from their wedding go to a charity supported by the Archbishop, who played such an important role on the day. Forsey says that this donation will help Feeding Britain to sustain their programs until schools reopen. The social and economic consequences of coronavirus have sent shockwaves across the Feeding Britain network. Families living in poverty, who were already struggling to access and afford food, have been put at even greater risk of hunger. He added that the money, which is expected to arrive this week, will keep breakfast, lunch and dinner, so three square meals, on the table of many tens of thousands of children across our network. Feeding Britain works across 12 areas in the UK to pilot new approaches to solving hunger. During the COVID-19 pandemic, the charity is also forming new partnerships in London and Scotland, and is running an emergency food program providing hot meals and food packages via home delivery and collection points for those in need. The spokesperson said. The Duke and Duchess were able to speak to the Archbishop recently, and were moved to hear all about the work Feeding Britain was doing to support people during COVID-19. They have particularly fond memories of their visit to the Citizens' Supermarket in Birkenhead, especially the generosity and compassion of everyone working there to help others. They are delighted to be able to ensure this money is donated to such a great cause. Another report. The graffiti artist, Keith Beale, drew a picture of the Duke of Sussex in a blue hoodie along with the words, "Keep calm and wash hands." A graffiti artist has shown some compassion and warmth towards new Los Angeles residents Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, who recently moved there. The artist, Keith Beale, drew a picture of the Duke of Sussex in a blue hoodie along with the words, "Keep calm and wash hands." He had also drawn a blue French bulldog and an orange pitbull on either side of Prince Harry, with a message of peace. Keith Beale captioned the image. "Awesome to have such a cool couple living in Los Angeles now. They seem to be adjusting nicely. Harry walking pups wearing his old Megxit hoodie that still comes in handy." In an interview with People, the graffiti artist explained, "I didn't like the way the president welcomed them to the country by saying, 'Hey, we're not going to pay for your security.'" The artist revealed, "So I wanted to try to find a way to use this image and welcome them at the same time to make a comment and a little public service announcement to everybody. I wanted to use their saying and put 'wash your hands' in there to update it with what's going on with the COVID-19. That's my way of welcoming them, the Los Angeles hoodie for Harry," he added. Inspired by the motivational poster the UK government had used to recruit soldiers in 1939 for the Second World War, Bill decided to put his own twist on the phrase, "Keep calm and carry on." The portrait is located at the intersection of Franklin Avenue and Beechwood Drive in the Los Feliz neighborhood. It is one among many graffiti murals that define the culture of Los Angeles. While speaking of the couple's move to Los Angeles, Bill shared, "I think that we're pretty stoked to have them here." He added, I mean, when you have a couple like that living amongst you, in my opinion, it kind of raises the bar. It raises the level of what you want to aspire to. He then spoke about Prince Harry and said, I would love to see more stuff of him done because I think he's an inspiration to kids that are in the new generation. To me, Harry is kind of a hero. Instead of being the spare, mind you, he's doing his own thing. I think that's great. Trump had taken to social media to share, I am a great friend and admirer of the Queen and the United Kingdom. It was reported that Harry and Meghan, who left the kingdom, would reside permanently in Canada. Now they have left Canada for the US. However, the US will not pay for their security protection. They must pay. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have both been very vocal about their dislike for Trump in the past. Meghan had snubbed the US president at a Buckingham Palace last year. In other news, the real reason Prince Harry is having a really hard time in Los Angeles. Prince Harry may be out of his comfort zone. Ever since the Duke of Sussex stepped down as a senior royal and moved to Los Angeles with wife Meghan Markle and their son Archie Harrison, things have been quite difficult for him. According to People, Harry's good friend, conservationist Jane Goodall, spoke to reporters about the prince's new lifestyle. Despite his confidence in the future, he has found everything up until now to be a bit challenging. The famed primatologist and anthropologist explained that she's been in contact with Harry since Medsit, and she sees it's been tough for him to adapt to his new way of life after having been born into royalty. Let's take a closer look at what life has been like for Harry since stepping down. Prince Harry's exit from the monarchy. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle officially dropped out of the monarchy on March 31, 2020. After their exit, they traveled to Canada, where they stayed for weeks in a secluded mansion on Vancouver Island. After that, they made the move to California, where they are now living. Though they're reportedly searching for a permanent home in Los Angeles, they're currently staying in a private compound in the area. While it was Meghan's dream to return to her hometown, she has also been having a tough time since Mexit, mostly because she's been unable to visit her mother, Doria Ragland, amid the coronavirus pandemic. Still, when the crisis clears, she and Harry will reunite with Ragland and continue on with their projects. As fans know, Meghan and Harry are leaving their Sussex royal brand behind, at Queen Elizabeth's request, and continuing to support the causes they so cherish with their new organization Arcowell. Due to the COVID-19 crisis though, everything has been postponed. Prince Harry's new life with Meghan Markle. While Prince Harry doesn't seem to regret his decision to exit the palace, resigning his royal duties and leaving his family behind was always going to be a hard choice. In March 2020, one of Harry's oldest friends told Vanity Fair, "It's an emotional time for him in many ways. I think in many ways it's bittersweet. He's always wanted to have a regular life and to get away from the spotlight, and that's what he's doing, but it basically means walking away from his family. Harry's a loving, loyal guy, so that will be very hard for him." Harry even admitted to the struggle in his speech at his Centibel charity event in January 2020. "It brings me great sadness that it has come to this. The decision that I have made for my wife and I to step back is not one I made lightly. It was so many months of talks after so many years of challenges. And I know I haven't always gotten it right, but as far as this goes, there really was no other option." So, will the prince be okay in his new life? The answer appears to be yes, it'll just take some time to adjust. Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.